Yo, what is up, guys?
What up?
We are back. I am back for the next few races again. Together with my boy XX Rider. If you haven't checked out
the man himself.
If you haven't checked out the picture that I just uploaded on Facebook, you gotta check it out because
go check it out.
It was a glorious picture. Wait. We will show it soon. But we have the next match here. It is Coco against Brand. So we have two Frenchies against each other, the only French people that are playing here. And it's going to be Coco against Brand. Now, Coco, did he play in Gamers Assembly? I think he did, right?
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he can be really quick and really fast. So this is going to be an interesting match. Of course, Brand, known for his performance at ZRT Cup, where he got second in the big tournament. So he is a very up-and-coming player. He is, of course, joined in Team Dignitas, so very, very high-skilled player here. I am really looking forward to what he can do in this match and in this particular format as well, because it's something new, it's something different, and let's see what he can do. Who do you think is going to come out on top of this match?
Oh, that's a very, very good question. But I think I must say Brand, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know how I should rate Coco on these type of maps. It's going to be a very close match, actually, I think. And I hope that we will see some close rounds. All the matches besides the first one were actually pretty one-sided, to say the least. And we're going to have Brand against Coco. They got 7th and 8th in the go-karting, so that's why they're playing against each other. And I think Brand is not playing with a headset, not sure. But
full Revo style?
Looking at his face, he's pretty ready. So, I'm not sure if we are live. This is warm-up, of course. Yeah. It says on the screen. We're gonna...
The question is if Brand can no-slide, neo-slide.
He can, actually. He did learn it, but he's not super confident in neo sliding, so that's another thing. So we are live right now on the first map. We see Brand going to the left, driving with the French car, and Coco also driving with the French car, of course.
French Master Race.
It's a bit unfortunate that they are both driving without HUD, so we cannot really see who's ahead or who's not. So hopefully the admins will give us some good overviews. But we see Brand making a big mistake early on, and that is a critical part as well. Like on the freewheeling.
Yep, that is the most terrible place to crash on this map.
You really don't want that to happen, but this looks like a very slow round by both players. Even though Brand crashed, of course, he is not playing that confident on this round. And I think Coco had a faster time than Brand on go-karting, or not?
Yeah. Coco was the... Or was he?
Or was Brand? I can't remember. But anyway...
No, Brand was.
All right,
sorry.
So Brand chose this map. It's the most difficult map, I would say.
Yep.
From all of them. And first round will go to Coco pretty convincingly after that mistake by Brand. So there it is. 1-0 for Coco. He is, of course, from Team AAA. Very known French organization. And let's see what Brand can do here. Coming up to the next round, he has to go right, and he will choose to do so.
I don't think we have seen that many people making a mistake in the start.
No, exactly. Yeah, well, it only happens like in the middle of the round, more like, not exactly at the start. Well, we saw Shorty, I think, make that mistake.
Yeah, Massa as well against me.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I thought Brand was going to the left there. But it seems like Coco is again in the lead. Yeah, slightly, 0.3 actually. In the lead. Here we go with the overview. Very close.
A little bit more speed though.
It's very, very close here. As we come up to this left turn, Coco barely touches the wall, but still manages to keep his speed. Coming up to the ending, we know that after the hairpin, it is one turn left until we enter the long stretch.
Great turn by both players.
It's 600s between these players.
Coco.
And Coco! Big mistake by Coco.
Completely mistimed it.
That's going to be a point for Brand. And 59-49, so not the quickest, but he is doing good.
But yeah, that was a very tight round until the last turn there, the last U-turn.
It is currently 1-1 on this first map. go. Coco has to go to the left now. Or to the right. Oh, just kidding. To the right. Not to this turn. This grass part is very tricky because you have to hit this right or left turn. Very good. And oh my god. Coco clips the wall before the freewheeling. And he will probably lose like 2 or 3 seconds by doing that. And this is a great opportunity for Brand to take this round. But he's not progressing real quick on this grass part. But still ahead. He is going
quite
this
a comfortable
part.
Lead though for yeah. For Brand.
But the thing is, he didn't switch HUD on, so he doesn't know that his opponent is like 2 or 3 seconds behind. That's the thing here. But he has one hairpin left. Look at Brand steering with his head, though.
Yeah, quite the common thing among the Trackmania players.
Look at him.
Yeah.
There he is.
I remember you do it as well sometimes.
Yeah. Of course I do it.
Yeah.
There we have it. 59.10 by Brand. Clearly improving his times. We might see some 58s coming up soon.
And a sip of that Red Bull as well.
Yeah, it's going to give him wings.
Getting pumped.
Wings that he needs to beat Coco here. Let's go into round number 4 on this map. Coco, though, looking very calm. And like I said, I don't really know what to expect from him on the land. I believe he got the... I don't know what he placed in the Gamers Assembly tournament either. I think he came pretty far, but I'm not sure.
And he's quite a good full speed player as well. I recall.
On this map, though, we see Coco slightly ahead of his opponent, Bran. Coming up to this tight section, left, right, quick turns. And Coco makes the mistake, gets the no slide. And there it is. Oh, Bran! What was that?
I think he got the ram there.
He got the ram and went to his front wheels. Oh. Like, that was... Oh, it makes another mistake. And that is a pity. There we go. On the long straight, Coco takes this round as Brand had some mistake on the Ramstein. Pretty unfortunate. I am constantly battling flies here.
It's better than battling a bee, like
that's,
I was.
That's true. That's true. So equal points now, 2-2 in this first map. It is, of course, the map chosen by Marius. By Brand. Oh, Coco makes a mistake before the freewheeling.
Licking the wall.
Brand also made a silly turn there. So...
But Coco with absolutely no speed at all.
Yeah, that's very unfortunate. Like, Brand has to make a huge mistake if Coco wants to have a chance this round. It doesn't look like it. He is around almost 3 seconds behind, so... Oh, and makes another mistake. So, mistakes are building up left and right for Coco. That's a bit unfortunate. But Brand here will take another point. It's going to be 3-2 for him on this first map. Looking very good. Coco makes another mistake, so it's just mistake after mistake.
Let's hope he can pull himself together until the next round, because that is something that gets to your head.
He definitely needs to get at least 2 more points, because it is not looking too good for Coco on this map. 3-2 now for Brand. Both of these players are actually driving with controller and with camera too, so that makes it even more easier to check who's ahead and who's not.
Did you see what Coco did there?
No.
Did
he try to zigzag?
No, in the chat he writes R or L.
Oh, what does that mean?
In the team chat, if he should go left or right.
Oh, okay. Oh!
That's pretty clever.
No,
so each round here he writes
what
he should drive next round. That's a good tactic, actually.
That's good, actually, yeah. And it's allowed, so...
Yeah.
Pretty good, but then again, Coco is failing this round miserably again, almost 3 seconds behind. So, this is not looking good for Coco. Brand will most likely get map point here if he manages to reach the finish line. Hairpin, and then you have one turn left on the long stretch. You will get it fairly easy. There he goes, onto the long stretch. Coco is now entering it.
Ooh, Coco.
That was very risky,
super
though.
Super risky, yeah.
There he goes. 59.32. Doesn't need to go quicker. But there we have it. Coco actually blowing air out of his mouth. Like
disappointment?
Yep.
Most likely.
He did right again, left or right, so pretty good tactic. Yeah, and it is allowed, so here we go. Map point for Bran as they are coming up to this grass part. Haven't seen big mistakes so far. Oh, bad speed by Coco again. He is not getting the hang of this map, that's for sure. But he is actually ahead. 700s, to say the least.
What happened to Bran?
I thought Bran maybe made the mistake and thought he had to go the other way. But wow, very close round here. We have 300s between these players. There he goes. Coco still leading, but it is very minimal. Can he hold this? Hairpin upcoming. Bran goes very close to the corners.
Will he manage Coco!
Coco makes a mistake, risking it too much. And this will be map point. And with the win for Bran on this map. There they go. It's actually pretty close, like 0.5 maybe, 0.6. And yeah, 0.5 exactly. There it is. 5-2 for Bran on that first map. So Bran is playing a bit comfortable here.
Yeah. Indeed, a lot of small mistakes from Coco. He started out pretty strong.
Exactly.
With quite the advantage over Bran in the first couple of rounds, but you know, those mistakes, they start to build up in the end.
Exactly. I didn't think he had one clean run. Well, the first one, maybe.
The first one, yeah.
That is a bit unfortunate for Coco. Maybe hopefully he can get himself back on track in the second map. It is, of course, the map that is chosen by himself. So we might see some good performance by Coco. They are doing some stuff right here. Unfortunately, cannot see what's happening. I guess they are switching the maps right now. I take a sip of this Red Bull. Of course, when we have the time here, we can thank the sponsors. It's this event is all sponsored by three big names in the electronic environment.
Yeah.
We have Intel, of course, Asus, and Alza. They are providing everything for this tournament to happen. And
we have it into the warm-up.
This is going to be the first warm-up on this round. This is the cousin map, I think, right?
This is Sparko map.
I still don't know the maps. That is
nope, me neither. I was
that is pretty damn good.
When they ask me what map, I just oh, Sparko.
Yeah, I just don't know the maps yet. But then again, this map very difficult, especially the ending with the Neo drift.
Also in the mid part, there was
This going into the cacti here for Bran on this long stretch. Now it is decided that it is not an auto drift. It is indeed you have to get the smooth landing from the wall, and then you have to slide again. So no auto drift there. But here we go, Bran with amazing Neo drifts. He is gonna show us how it's done here.
He's laughing it off as well.
There we go. 5-2 in favor of Bran. If he takes this map with 5-0, that would be so great for him. But here we go. Round number one.
Let's see which way Bran chooses right as well.
Yep. And they will make the jump, of course, into this section. The players will meet here on the platform. Now it is important to get a good landing here, because there is a landing bug available. Like, it's free, but you just don't want to get it. Let's follow Bran here, who is slightly ahead, coming up to this very speedy part. Left, right, quick turning, and onto the dirt we go.
Coco trying to zigzag on the dirt as well.
Is it useful to do that in such a small...
I'm not sure. I heard one guy saying that there is a gear up, so it won't affect anything, but let's see at the end of the
The end. Oh, Coco with a small bump. Bran makes it. Coco makes it as well, but Bran is far, far ahead. So drives us for a good time. 58.64. Now, that is not far off from the author time. The author time is 57.73 here. So, there we go, there we go. 6-2 now, total score for Bran.
Oh! Both players going the same way in the start.
Is that allowed?
No.
I'm not.
I think it was Coco.
It is. It's.
I think Coco gets a two-second penalty for that one.
Hmm. Are you sure?
Who went wrong? Look, they're both going left now. Yeah, Brent started going. No, Coco went right.
Coco is going right.
So
now
it's Brent.
Coco is wrong here. So Coco will get a two-second penalty. Even though he didn't get a checkpoint, it was just the first turn, but rules are the rules here. And Coco will get the penalty. Bran must feel very comfortable because he will win this round and then also the next round most likely. Oh, Bran's Neo slide!
Oh, and Coco retires.
Yeah, he was wrong. And no, he could have still won.
He could have won it, though. But there again, we see the chat with Coco riding in.
Yep. So Coco gets a two-second penalty.
Has to wait in the start.
Yep, there he goes. 1-2 can start now. And of course, if Bran makes the same mistake he did previous round in the end, he could...
Oh, what? Coco going right again?
Coco taking the wrong way again.
Or was it Bran? Bran went left last time.
What's happening,
what
man?
What is going on? Who's supposed to go which way?
Wait, Bran chose right first? I have no idea what's going on.
I'm speechless here. Anyone in the chat knows what's going on?
The brain lag.
Oh, shit.
The brain lag. Bran has to go left.
Yeah, you're right. He should go left.
Bran has to go left.
You messed up.
Bran, you messed up, boy.
You messed up real good.
Wait, they're both waiting 2 seconds?
No, I think they're just...
I'm so confused. Oh, okay. All right. So it's even now again.
Yeah.
All right, so we're even because Coco did the first mistake and then Bran did it after. So now we're even again. Man, the brain lags.
Yeah.
All right, so here we go. Good. This is good. Nice.
Ooh.
Players
well, there can also be some mind games in this one. I tried it with Masa, but he's just stone cold. But if you zigzag the opposite way that you're supposed to go start...
It's very misleading.
Yeah.
For your opponent, exactly. But here we go. This round looks very close. Seems like... Oh, Bran with the no slide.
Both Coco and Bran with the no slide.
Yeah, but Bran's crash was way worse. Oh, that was very unfortunate stuff for Bran. And this is must be a round for Coco. He definitely needs it because he's 5 points behind. That is a lot of points. So he is finding his way back to the end. Can he survive this part?
Oh, yeah. He will.
And Bran again with the nose slide. Oh, here he goes. Way! Shows off the Neo slide. He can actually... he can do it. But then again... Coco gets the point. Here we go. Will Bran still remember what way he has to go? Yes, they both do. Good stuff, good stuff. Wait. Oh, the mind games are Bran. He goes the other way around the pole. It is allowed, though. So, here he goes. Bran. Oh, ooh. Bran jumps. Can he go over? No, no RPG skills either. No Neo slides, no RPG. Damn.
So
feels
that was
bad, man.
Another point here for Coco.
What?
Oh,
and
yeah.
A brain lag. But that Bran already retired.
Oh,
what is this match? Feels bad, man, in chat.
But yeah, that part can be very confusing because you have a lot of speed going up to it.
Damn.
And the turns look kind of the same, but
that this rounds. So here we have Bran. Of course, he retired so early. He could have just backed out and then made it.
Oh!
Imagine he missed the finish.
Imagine that, yeah.
Okay, he does make it though. All right, here we go. 2-2. Do they still remember where to go? Yes, they do. Here we go. Will he? Will Bran actually make this dirt jump now? That's the question. He will do so. It looks very close at this point of the map, at least. Oh, bad transition for Bran, who has lost a little bit of speed.
Coco, though, with tons of speed here.
Yep. Whoa, he got that slide. That was good. This could be a good time, though.
Yep. Going look really far. Bumps.
He is far ahead.
Not zigzagging on the dirt anymore.
He is really far ahead. But can he make it till the end? Oh, that's a good... He did get it smooth. Smooth. And here we go. Coming up to the ending. Coco.
Can he get the last Neo?
He will get the slide. Bran will also get the slide. But Coco is far ahead. And this is a good time. 58.09. That is the closest time we've seen so far to the author time, I think. Of course, 57.81 is the... No, not 81. 73 is the score here. So 7-5 now in total. Still in favor of Bran. It is looking good for Bran, but Coco is making a slight comeback here. He was 7-2 behind. And here we go. Next round.
Yeah, he got three consecutive rounds here.
Another nice view. Split up left and right. The players go very speedy part here. Now this drift is very tricky. I think Coco will get more speed out of this, but
yeah,
what
a turn!
Did he release that?
I think he
has
had to release.
Yeah. That was very tight.
But Bran is looking to have a very good round here.
Yep.
Sadly, he just
He went too early down on the, but he's still ahead.
What a save!
So close, but coming up to the ending, this is like when you have the pressure. It's very goes for the wall bang.
What?
He is trying some trickster here. He did lose a lot of speed. Will he actually win? He does. And that might be actually a good thing.
Yeah. Because that'll save you at least the nose light.
That might actually be a good thing.
I'm not sure if it's faster, but it's definitely safer. That's for
sure. Like, if you do it full speed, then, man, that's good. So, let's see if Bran does it again for this round. Did a wall bang there.
Coco not with the best start.
No, it's actually 0.4 behind very early on and has to make a comeback in this round. Here he goes to the very speedy part. Look at Bran's head. He's almost falling over. Oh, the cactus came very close to Coco there. But...
Coco!
Huge mistake!
No, and face planned as well from the guy himself.
Damn, huge mistake by Coco. And now, let's see if Bran will do the wall bang again. Let's see here. He does do it. I think you can actually do it full speed after. You don't have to slide,
I think.
He's
shaking his head, though.
Yeah, true. But I don't think you have to break after. You just wall bang and then...
Full speed it?
Get the turn correct. So, map point here for Bran. And, he is on his way to win this match. His first match, of course. Here they go. Onto this start jump. Splitting up. Say hi to each other. There they go. And onto the next meeting point. Wow. Bran. Oh, gets the land bug. I think it's because he landed with four wheels. And that's what Tween said. Earlier, you should make sure that you land with two wheels to not get the bug in that particular part.
So no air brake?
No air brake. Coco here.
Oh, Coco with the slowdown on the dirt.
Yeah, but he's still ahead. He had a 1.4 second lead, actually. So he could afford to get the that slowdown. This will most likely be a round for Coco here, as he comes up to the ending. Brand doing it again. The angle might be a bit off, but he's trying. He's trying to find some tricksters. Of course, very good player. 4-4 now, here we go. Map point for both of these players. I think Coco wants this point more than ever.
Oh, yeah.
But Bran, if he can deny Coco this round, he only needs one more, actually, to at least get a draw out of this match. Here they go. Oh, Bran had to release. Bran had to release. And
so slight advantage for Coco in the start of
exactly, and he makes a full stop pick. Full stop.
Oh,
at the start, and this is so good for Coco.
I guess Coco is about to know. Doesn't he take hard on and off? No, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't. He's there. He sees it now.
Yeah.
Yep, definitely.
Three
there
and
he
half
goes.
Seconds.
He knows, and he will most likely save it until the ending here.
Has
no reason to risk. Brando will lose his round, and this was critical round for him. Here they go.
So yeah, Coco taking this map. There we go.
There it is. Coco wins this map. So score now 9-7. Still in favor of Bran. But it is not as easy as he would have expected it. And I expected it to be very easy also, actually.
Yeah, Bran was looking really good in the start of
of
the map, but kind of lost it in the end.
Yep, coming up to this third map now. This might be...
MD point?
MD point map. And Coco will choose his side. There it is. He has to write it in the chat. So yeah, we're gonna play MD point, and I think Coco will go for the right turn again. That's what he has always been choosing. So let's see. Let's see.
There we go. Changing to the map.
Changing to spark, I mean MD point. So they will do one warm up. They are switching some stuff. I'm not sure what's happening, but will the penalty move to your next match? That is actually that's actually a very good question, Milmi. I will ask that later, or maybe somebody else in the chat can answer that question, because I'm not sure, because you will be playing a completely new opponent, so it would be weird if you would play a new opponent and then you get the penalty against him
and just start with the penalty.
Yeah, that's pretty weird, but then again, we don't know yet. We are warming up here, I think. Who's casting with me? It is XX Rider.
Your boy.
Who is casting with me. But here we have the warm up on MD points map. This is a very smooth map. Like, that's what he's known for. MD point makes good use of the new blocks. Especially the platform pieces that you see here. Always very, very smooth transitions. So here we go. This is, of course, the last map of this match. And the score is 9-7 in favor of Bran. But anything can still happen. It all depends on this map. Who will win this match.
Oh, and the warm-up here is looking super close between the two players.
Yep. Very close. Ooh, Brand turns into early, as well as Coco. Both making the same mistake.
And they are not able to make the jump.
Yep. Here. Well, you can actually take the booster there on the left.
Yeah, true.
That is what Shorty was doing.
Thanks
when
for telling
he didn't
me now.
That is what he was doing. He chose the booster to still make the jump.
Our favorite to win this tournament.
Who is my favorite? I already said my top three earlier. It was Kappa, Bran, and Massa will be top three. That's what I'm thinking about. But then again, anything can happen. It is Trackmania, and
you
with
don't
this
have
mode,
last year's winner as top three?
No. And
nope.
Nope. And this this match here is gonna decide a lot. Is Bran gonna feel comfortable, or will Coco make the comeback? He's of course two rounds behind, and Bran makes a mistake, clips the wall. And this could be an easy round for Coco here. Get another point on the scoreboard and battle his way back up there. Here we go, here we go. 9-7, of course. Both players will make the jump, but this ending, ooh, Coco lost his gear. What? This could be a good opportunity for Bran to take over, but
not
it all
sure
depends
he has
here.
The speed.
Ooh, it is very close though. Came back strong there in the end. But
Coco,
Coco
though, up till that point looks pretty comfortable on this map.
Exactly, exactly.
And the lead is only up to 1 point now for Bran.
It is looking very good here for Coco. He found his momentum. Won two rounds in a row now after mistakes from Bran though. So,
Bran,
they both make the mistake actually.
Yeah.
Same mistake, and Coco is so far ahead already. Oh, this is not good for Bran. He is not finding his groove on this map. It's almost 1.5 seconds, maybe 2 seconds behind, I guess. Not the best landing for Coco there, but still finds himself in the lead. Here we go. Closing in on that finish line. Ooh, both players saw each other there. Of course, Coco still leading this round. Coming up to this fast turn. Gotta keep your gear near the ending. I believe it's coming up in this turn, the right-hander. Will they both make it? Coco gets the higher gear, Brandon as well, but Coco's still far ahead compared to Brandon, and he will actually get first over this finish line. So ties up the score, 9-9. Bran has to do something about that. It's not looking good.
Nope, and Coco now with the confidence after winning so many rounds in a row. Like last map, Bran had the advantage. I think he had 4 points.
Yep.
And Coco took 4 consecutive rounds in a row. And with this one, it makes it 6.
Exactly, exactly. So here we go, another round, another challenge. It is make it or break it for Bran now. He found himself with a slight lead previous maps, but right now it is looking like he is losing it, but that was very close. Barely made the turn.
Super close already.
Yep, 100 between these players. Coco is actually having a slight lead. Now this is coming up all the way to the end. 500s between these two players. Who will make the first minor mistake?
Bran taking the early lead.
It is looking like Bran has overtaken Coco, but maybe that was because of the inside line. Yes, it is. 300s now in between these two players coming up, both with the high gear.
No,
Coco
with the low gear.
Coco loses his gear, and it is Bran who will stay ahead. Coming up to this ending, definitely Bran with like 0.2 of a sec ahead. There it is. 101.94. That is a very good time. And that was the first really close round up until the end.
And there we see the chat from Coco. So, a 1 point lead now for Bran.
Yep.
10-9.
And Bran, if he takes 2 more rounds, then he has won this matchup. So, that is very good for him. Here we go. 10-9. Can he extend the lead? Now, Coco with a big mistake early on. And this is another great opportunity for Bran to get that at least draw out of this matchup. If he gets 11 points, he will have the draw. For sure, it is 0.3 seconds between these players. They see each other, and Bran has made a mistake. Coco has actually caught up from the mistake, and Bran makes another mistake. Approaches the turn very, very widely, and goes into the... What?
It retires as well.
That was a choke by Bran. Coco now will get back in the points, 10-10. Brando with the choke, Reno. Man, he was 0.3 ahead, and then he threw it away with one small, three mistakes in a row. That was a very, very bad for Bran. Here we go, here we go. 10-10.
Yep.
All equal again. Coco can even win this match. Who would have thought that after he was... I think the score was 7-2 at one point of this match.
Yep.
7-2 and he came back all the way. That is...
Well, Bran has made quite the many mistakes.
Yes, exactly.
During this match.
That is true, that is true. He has made some mistakes and Coco is just using it in his favor, basically. That is what he is doing. Bran here again is a little bit behind. And it looks like Coco will take this round sooner or later. It is looking good here. Coco is 0.3 ahead. No, 0.2. What am I saying? 23 hundredths ahead of Bran here. 42 hundredths now. And this could be the first time Coco will actually lead in points on this in this match.
And it's a very good time to start leading.
Ooh, look at this. Coco will get first here. 101.85. Coco is putting some better gas in his car. And oh, maybe he found actually the boost button.
Like in the go-karts?
On the go-karts. But 11.10 now. This is match point for Coco.
Yeah, indeed.
Match point for Coco here.
Bran has to win 5 rounds in a row if he wants to.
It is... Well, there's only 3 more laps to go, actually. So, no, 2, actually. If Coco loses this one, we will have a decider on the next round. But this is looking good for Coco. Finds himself in the lead. 0.16 already. And here we go. On to the drop to the right. Coco. It is going very tight in this corner. Bran actually risking the border. Will that pay off? 0.11 now. But he goes too wide again, makes a mistake, and that is GG. It is match point, GG.
No
Coco
one saw
wins.
This coming, wow.
Coco wins.
What a comeback from Coco there.
That is unexpected. Bran lost, and Coco is victorious. All right, so Coco wins the match against Bran.
Wow.
Who would have thought that? That was very unexpected. We have two Frenchies. Bran is lost in this run. He had a 5-point lead. 7-2 at one point, and he just threw it away completely.
I'm looking forward to see what Bran has to say.
We
like
will have a
what happened.
Yeah, we will have a short interview, of course. We'll have a short interview with both of them to ask what happened. And of course, it is not the end of Bran. He can still play good in the second two matches that he has. But here we go. Getting them on the couch here. So make sure you're... no, this one. There we go. Mics are on. We are ready to ask some questions. So, Bran, what happened?
just didn't perform well on the last lap, I guess. It could have been way better since I had a lot of advantage.
Yes. Yeah, you had, at one point, you were seventh. This one? This one is off. All right. Well, rip microphone. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, you had a 7-2 lead, actually.
Yeah, today. Quite good in the first map. While Coco did some mistakes, and then the opposite happened in the last map.
Exactly.
So I didn't play well. He deserved the win.
All right. Coco, how did you feel about this match? Were you nervous or?
I was so nervous, dude. And I honestly feel like I only won because of Bran's mistakes. Especially on the last map, I was so choking. I didn't know what find the word.
And also on the second map, actually, your ending was way better compared to Bran's.
Yeah.
He made some mistakes, then he decided to try out the wall bang.
Yeah,
I know it looked at first. I was like, "Wow, I'm impressed that you found this," but it wasn't that quick in the end. So definitely a slide there that brought you back into the race. So what do you have for a question, Ryder?
I would like to say it was a pretty sick comeback you had there.
Yeah.
How do you feel? Did you get into a groove or?
I'm used to come back since my Canon matches in 2012. So yeah, when someone is ahead, I was like, I'm like out of my mind, and I'm playing better and better.
Uh-huh.
And the opposite happens to Grant here. So perfect for me.
Yep, you definitely. Like I think many people, like, this is not gonna sound BM. Well, maybe sound BM, but I think everyone was expecting Brand to win this round, and you just showed everyone difference. Even though it's a slight, it's only 1 point difference, or two actually, 2 point difference. Yeah. You definitely deserve to win this match after Brand making so many mistakes. Maybe he was just. Were you actually nervous coming into this match? On like you were also not playing with a headset, and like did that impact you or?
Nervous at the beginning,
uh-huh.
since I won a few rounds, but then when Coco caught up to me,
yeah,
I became like shaky and stuff, so yeah, just made me nervous. And
all right. So maybe a question here, what are you gonna change up for the next match? Do you think you will approach or maybe choose a different map first, or what do you think?
Actually, Coco picked the first map.
Yes,
since he was better than me. Uh-huh. I think on the next match, I will play with a headset.
Uh-huh.
Just to make sure I can focus on the game.
Yeah, I think you should have done that from the start, actually. Just play with... what's happening with the mic?
No idea.
Oh. You press mute. You cannot press this button. It's a mute button. It's a
Jesus,
mute button. All right, whatever.
I have a question here. What went through your heads when all the things happened with going the wrong way?
Oh,
That was quite confusing for everyone, I guess.
Yeah.
First, Coco got the penalty, mm-hmm. and then I got one since I completely mixed with the roads, like I went left instead of right and stuff. So we got two penalties, so we got to cancel them to get to start at the same time, mm-hmm. as the 2 seconds were useless at this time. So yeah, it was confusing.
Yeah, I was so confused. When that happened, I was like, wait, what's happening? I have no idea what's happening. But apparently you made the first mistake, and then he made one mistake, so it got equal again, man, and then it all fixed itself again. But yeah, thanks for being here on the interview. I guess we have the group stage scores right here. Of course, all of these players will have two more matches to play. Of course, Massa here, one win, plus 13. That's his difference in round scores. That's a big, big, big difference. So, yeah, here we have the group stage results. We will have two more matches. Everyone that has to play, two more matches. So, don't go anywhere, of course.
Results are up, I guess. It's in the chat.
Yeah, results are up. I think it's this link here in the chat right now. Challenge?
Round two.
Yes, challenge. So round two is actually ready already. Ready already.
Ready
so,
already.
So we will maybe quickly go over the rounds here. What?
First match is Marius.
Oh, first match is going to be Marius versus Hobby. Then we also have, I'm not sure in what order this is going to be played, but Revolution against Bran. Hockey Junior against XX Rider. Massa against Kappa. Now this is gonna be a killer of a match. I'm gonna tell you that. We also have Race Hans against Tween, and then we have Shorty against Coco. So this round selection is
Race
based
Hans versus Tween as well.
Yeah, this is based on the rounds difference, the score points. So if, for example, the two worst players will play against, I mean, the worst player will play against the worst player, and the best player will play against the best player. So it's very equal stuff here. Of course, this is the second round, and then we also have a third round that we will be playing. But yeah, I'm not sure when that is going to happen. I'm pretty confident that we have a 20 to 30 minute break now.
Yep.
20 minute break. I just heard it. So just going to relax, grab some food before we go. all right. Before we go to the next match, I want to thank everyone for tuning in already. Don't go anywhere. We have a lot more Trackmania content to come. So I'll see you guys in 20 minutes. Peace out.